Okay, Google. Increase the volume. Again.
Thank you.
Yo Suri Namaskar when you do it with music. Okay Google. Okay Google. Okay Google. Play. And then go up. Come down slowly and then down. Right? Again place this. Aesthetic when you do it. You enjoy your music. And then you are doing it. Come down. Yeah. So this was your. Now let me show you some of the aesthetic ones while sitting. Okay? Just follow. And then go back. And walk. Okay, slowly. Now this hand slowly. Along with your music. You can practice with any music there. You can again go. Both the hands slowly you can take up and stay there. Again back and back. Now slowly just down. Take your leg, cross it, and then Namaskar Pushpa. Back, cross this leg, and Namaskar. Now. Here. Now you are going to do Pavana Muktasana. okay? You're going to raise your leg, hold it here close to your chest, and then be like this, this position, and rotate. One, two, three, four, and relax. You can even rotate till 8 counts. Now bend this, take this leg, and rotate. Let your left elbow touch the ground. Come to the center and roll on your back forward and back like this. Now stretch your leg. Stay relaxed. Now slowly turn and tuck the stretch. So for today, as I showed you some of the asanas, lying down, then prone, then all these things, when you do it with the music, it will enhance your happiness, enhance your positive thinking. So it's not that we should have a lamp right in front and do it. This lamp is for some other reason. Mainly I will be coming to your eye exercise whenever I end up. So today we are going to do pranayams. Pranayam is 100% stress buster. So we all are stressed, staying at home. Everybody is stressed. We don't know. So many things are going around us. People are saying vaccine, those who are taken also is not safe. I mean, people are spreading so many negative messages around us. So let us all start doing this yoga and spread positiveness, happiness. And yoga is the best way we bust our stress. So just breathe in and breathe out. Anulom Vilom is breathing, exhale and inhale. So when we do with the fingers there, it becomes Chandra, Anulom Vilom, and there are so many variations. I don't want you to just confuse you. There is Chandra. So we are just going to do simple ones. Just fold your, this is one of the mudra, okay? And then just press your right, breathe in, and use the same place, same area for breathe out. Same nostril. Now block, breathe in through your right, and use the same passage for breathing out. Now again, block, left, breathe in. Breathe out. Now again block, right breathing, and breathe out. So this was one of the Anulom Vilom, just that is Chandra Anulom Vilom, okay? And another one is, you will have to just keep like this, and then breathing. This is what we normally do, okay? Breathing through your left, block it, breathe out from your right. So Anulom Vilom itself has so many variations, and Kapalbhati is another exhaling one. Yesterday I showed you, ready? Close your eyes and then breathe out. So this is 20 counts. I have showed you how to exhale. Just press your stomach. Just keep pressing your stomach. Okay, and now I'm going to tell you about Sikh curry, then you're going to names at all, you don't worry at all, just do the asanas. That is the reason I normally don't say the names, so that thinking of those names itself, we will just forget the complete sequence. So keep your tongue like a spoon. And breathing. You can feel the cool stomach, cool air passing through your tongue till your stomach. Again, keep your tongue like a spoon. Awesome, I'll tell you. Okay, and now you will have to kick both the teeth, okay, and then breathe in inside. Ready? Wow, really it's relaxing. Again, so you can do on either Vajrasana position or on Padmasana position or modified Padmasana position. Okay, so these are the Sikh curry, today's new asana, which you have been doing it, only thing you should be reminded. So these are the best ways we can keep ourselves meditation position. This is the best way to relax, this is the best way to bust our stress, and these are all happiness yoga. Whatever I show you, it makes you happy when you are doing full relaxation. Actually, when you are called, you have got relaxed, you will just walk free without any thought. You will just walk very freely as when you're walking so far and just making any sort of movement freely. Okay, that means he is not in stress. But if a child is sitting for a long and thinking, that means the child is unhappy. So bring the child in you, just see that you are doing your free movements, keep your body free, keep yourself stress free, just do the actions wherever you are, even in kitchen, just take a spoon and then add stress free food for everyone there. That's a story, you know, in a Sai Baba temple, it was told to me, and I want you people to listen to that story, for people whoever used to come. So those days there were sages who used to often go to their house and then have their one particular sage used to take all whomever he felt, okay, yes, I'll take for a lunch there, and he used to take for a lunch there. Okay, so very rarely he used to go as a guru. So this man, the man who was fond of that guru, he called that particular sage one day for a lunch, and his wife was very much happy to provide, but all of a sudden she fell sick. Okay, so now this time here wife was also not keeping her health, and sage also was not able to come for the lunch. So what he did, he sent his two people under him, he had some students, so he sent two students for having the lunch. So those two students went to this person who called, who invited for the lunch. These two people went for the lunch, they had their lunch, and then they came back. But what happened when they went, there was a very costly serving vessel which was very favorite to him, that was missing. So this man got really annoyed. He was like very much fond of sages, he was very much fond of the students, sage students, and he was very much fond of giving, serving people. So when he saw that particular favorite vessel missing, he was really annoyed and he got upset, how come my guru's students are like this? So he went to the guru and he said, Guru, the two students whom you sent, one of them stole my very favorite vessel. Then Guru said, how come I send my favorite students there, I send my very honest student there, and how come they stole it? So he just wanted to know whether they really stole it, and then when he called those two people, and then he came to know that yes, it one of them has brought the quiz. So he was not happy at all, and he wanted to know how come his students, such a favorite student, has done it. So he just went back to the person's house who invited for the lunch. So when he went back, he asked whether did you cook, whether it was you who cooked, whether your wife cooked. And then he said, sorry Guru, I'm really sorry. Actually, always says my wife used to cook, but that day my wife became sick. So I called one of the lady to cook that day. So when it was inquired about that lady, she used to steal from people's house wherever she was. So it was she who cooked, and she, her food which was cooked, has brought the change in the students. So this cooking and the food we take matters a lot. Whoever cooks and the food which is cooked by them matters a lot. So whoever is listening to me, this is a message which I received from a Sai Baba temple, because actually we were waiting for the Annadhanam there, and then they said, please have the Annadhanam which we are providing, Annadhanam material, from only those people who are really willing. We don't force anyone to give it with hatred. So everything matters. Every rice has everyone's name there, each one's name. So let us all be truthful, let us all be happy, let us be stress free. Yes, incidents happen, yes, all this pandemic will come and it will go, it may stay also with us, but let us be happy.